Hi, this is Wayne Tully, and today I'm going to draw a vampire skull. So I've just had an idea of drawing different variations of skulls and just putting them like in a playlist, you know, so there'll be lots of different variations of skull designs that you can have a go at, or, you know, I'll just look at, you know, because there's all sorts of variations that I've already drawn, which I'll compile in a playlist. So what I want to do, I want to get the base of the skull right first. Then I'll draw one right like that. Probably see the other eye, but that's smaller there than that eye. Skull nose slightly different. It's a vampire skull after all. What we can do is draw the cheekbones there and the teeth. Get the vampire teeth there. Give him a smaller fang there. Which you won't really see. So we've got that shape correct. We've got certain things going on there. Can add some shadow if you want. It doesn't have to be final within the drawing. We can just make it up as we go along. Across the bottom jawbone. There. This can be all shaded around the eyeball. Again, I keep forgetting about the inking stage because sometimes the ink pens clog. Ah, well, I'll just do that and just have to remember. Can do a smaller eye there. As long as you get the inner pupil in that one as well, and it'll match up quite well to that. So this cheekbone should be slightly lower, so we correct that. Be sunken there, which you don't see on this side because you see that bit on the side. So drawing the rough teeth here. One set of fangs there on the bottom. Now, as you can see, I've deliberately shortened the amount of teeth there. I just decided to draw some like chewing teeth there, like molar teeth or whatever. Mainly just because I felt like it. So I'm not really bothered about whether it doesn't look like a realistic type of skull, because vampire skulls don't really exist unless you're mad and you see him in the mirror. Then there we go. You can start to shade this in now. I think that's as far as I can go with it. I don't want to overkill it with too much detail or anything, but that's how you draw a vampire skull. So we'll probably add more to it. We might start inking it and colouring it. So yeah. Hi there, we're going to start to ink this vampire skull now. I'm going to ink it in a bit more detail though. Really just improve the drawing. over these vampire teeth. Cross hatching, usually works alright. So adding extra details as well. Shading. Extra details. And that's pretty much it for our vampire skull. Now we'll come back in another video and we'll start to colour this one. Yeah. Right, it's time to colour this vampire skull now. I've got a purple Crayola pencil. I'm just going to shade this pretty much like the zombie skull that I did, I'm going to layer in the purples again, yeah, but I want this to be more redder, I'd say, than like a purple colour, so I'm just layering in some of the shadows here. Shade outwards. under the ice there, only slightly. Said this before, when you're looking through this camera, this purple looks like a blue, so, you know, but it is purple now. So when you start to add in the reds, it'll look and it'll blend a lot better. Start to layer in red now. I'm laying it in a bit, you know, thicker and harder on this because I just want it to be, you know, like a red vampire skull. You see the purple, it shows up then. And that's just the effect I wanted to achieve with that, so. So there you see the red colour is looking more dominant over this purple now, and that's the way I wanted it really. You know, to make this more of an effective vampire skull, the red has to be like a blood colour. or to suggest like flesh on the skull or something like that. Choose your best the shade around the inclines that you've done, because it looks a lot better. Simple reason. And often you'll find where there's no ink inclines, you can do layer in some colour as well, which provides a nice contrast. Little phrase there. Catchphrase. Colouring the gaps on here as well, and the eye sockets. Do that in a no point doing any shading on this area because it's already dark anyway, and that's, you know, the effect that you want to achieve with it. So right, so what we need now is just to maybe blend this with some white, blend certain areas. Notice I've left white areas because I just want that to be white, you know, because it's like a skull after all. So you know, once you blend these colours together, it looks far more effective. And you can see it smooths over all the, you know, the pencil work. It's a nice smooth look, especially for like flesh colour without any skin on it or anything like that. So we can just pretty much leave it like that with white bits on it, and you know, it produces quite a nice effect. I'll come back to that. I'll do the eyes. I want these to be the only thing that don't seem to fit in with the, you know, current colour scheme. So I want these to be quite striking and bright, so they stand out as well. Let's get some brown on there, just shade outwards. Slightly on that one. Then we take the yellow and just press it on hard. Shade all around it. Doing the same on the other eye. I just like to leave them white right in the centre of the eye. So we can get back to smoothing all these over now. And the teeth, you can probably draw lots of blood on the teeth just for effect. able to draw colour it on different types of ways, because they'll be all covered in blood, but it will always be the same on each tooth. So maybe just draw different soaked areas like that. Maybe draw a slight bit of shadow, although not too much. Just on the underside there, just to give it a bit of tone and a bit of form there. We could just smooth all that over with the white again. There we have it, a nice vampire skull, coloured with Crayolas, super cheap. So I'll see you in the next video. Cheers now.